In this video, I will break down what you can use the in operator for and how it works. The in operator in DAX is something that wasn't there on the launch, but over time, Microsoft included this in the DAX language. And just like with many other languages, it can be used to input many OR operators in an easier way. Let's see how that works. So we're looking at the AdventureWorks sales right here, where the sales are split out over different colors. And perhaps you are the kind of person that likes the colors of the flag of your country a lot. So if you're from the Netherlands, you like red, blue, and white. So what you can do is, if you would select this red, blue, and white color, you could do it the standard way and just write things manually. Let's see how that works. Because by knowing how it works the manual way, we'll have a comparison on how in can make your life easier. So if we would look for the sales, and then red, blue, and white, or red, white, and blue, or blue, then what we can do is you can write yourself a calculate statement with the sales, and then you would write that the color has to equal red. Then by doing it manually, you have to write those two pipe symbols. This indicates that it's an OR condition. You can write color equals white, two pipe symbols, or your color equals blue. Now we can close our brackets. And by closing the brackets, the measure gets prepared. And if we put that in our matrix, and we're going to find that it shows us the same value everywhere. And the reason that it shows it for everywhere is because the way we wrote this down, it overrides the current color indication. So if you write black here, then actually the syntax here overrides black and replaces it by any of these. I'm writing it in this way right now because I want more than two OR conditions. It needs to be red, white, or blue. If in some case you would want to have something like just red and white, you could also use the OR expression, because OR allows you to have two logical inputs. But since we had three, actually this was the way to go. Now you can imagine that you keep on repeating yourself by doing this. Now if you don't like that, instead of having this syntax here, we could make another one with the in condition. So the in condition can be used to replace an OR condition. So in this case, I will add the in operator here. And to change your formula, the only thing you'll have to do is you write down that your color needs to be in, and you open your curly brackets. And from there on, you need to provide your desired values in a list. So that's between a curly bracket, and you just separate everything within there with a comma. Okay, we close it, and this is our new measure. And when we put our new measure in this table, you will find that the result of this is the same. Okay. Now, the in operator in this way can be expanded easily. I sometimes have very long lists if it's a manual exercise. And what I sometimes do is I go to Excel, I make my entire list there, and with the concatenate function, I'm able to paste it between these brackets. Sometimes you want the opposite. You just want to exclude items. In this case, you could also write the not operator before in. And by doing that, I'm getting a mistake. It should be a little bit earlier, I think. Not. Okay, here we go. So you wrap your not operator just around this one to get 38,000, which is the same as the 45 minus 7. Okay. And of course, if you just, let's remove this one for now. So we get back to our original measure. And if you want to return the value that will show you purely one of the colors, you could also wrap this around keep filters, and your in operator will still keep functioning. So by clicking enter, we now see the values for just these different ones. So that was a quick summary on how the in operator replaces the or condition. It's gonna make your life easier, and if this helped you in any way, please like it below, and I'll see you in the next video.